My BFI player choice this week was Sweden's entry for the International Feature Film category at the 92nd Academy Awards, a film that wraps its rebelliously empowering LGBT message within a tale told with extraordinary physical vigour. And Then We Danced. Levin Gelbakiani, a dancer who writer-director Levin Akin found on Instagram, plays Mirab, a young man who spent most of his life training to perform Georgian dance, a very specific art form which we're told is upright and as tough as a nail, the very embodiment of the noble Georgian spirit. Now, Mirab has a playful air to his dancing which is utterly frowned upon by his teachers. When new arrival Irakli replaces him in a key routine, Mirab feels humiliated and affronted. But there is something else beneath the rivalry, a spark that cannot be quelled. Meanwhile, we hear ominous tales of another dancer being run out of the company after being found with a man. Does Mirab run the risk of being similarly exiled? Akin was apparently inspired to make And Then We Danced after seeing footage of an attack upon a gay pride march in Georgia. When he approached the Georgian National Ballet to help with the film, they reportedly refused on the grounds that homosexuality does not exist in Georgia. During the shoot, threats were made against the production, while sell-out screenings of the finished film in Tbilisi prompted violent protests. Brilliantly, despite such opposition, And Then We Danced flies off the screen, telling its story with a bold eloquence that's a joy to behold. Believe me, I knew nothing of Georgian dance before watching the movie, but there's a universality to its language that makes this accessible to all. It really is a great example of show-don't-tell filmmaking, in which nothing speaks louder than the dance itself.